It was really timely that they named the stadium after Pete Shotwell.
I've always said, give me a quarterback and a great line coach and you're going to win some ball games, and at least move the football.
We never call ourselves ex-Eagles, we're just old Eagles.
That was a goal, to bring the bell back home. You know, this was its home in the 50s.
Welcome to the Legends of Texas High School Football, the Abilene Eagles. We're here in Abilene, Texas, where champions are made, the motto of the Abilene Convention and Visitors Bureau. And thank you very much for this very picturesque day here in the big country. In the next hour, we're going to introduce you to the people who helped shape one of the most successful high school football programs in the last century. From coaches like Pete Shotwell, Dewey Mayhew, Chuck Mosier, and Steve Warren, to the players like David Borland, Jimmy Carpenter, David Parks, John Lackey, Taylor Potts, to Herschel and Ronell Sims. We've got you covered. We'll gather around the table at the Strap House, as it is known, and discuss Abilene Eagle football with those who led the school to 49 consecutive victories. Plus, the modern era Eagles and how they ended a streak of their own with not only a playoff appearance, but a state title in 2009. It's all coming up on the Legends of Texas High School Football, the Abilene Eagles.
Herschel's in the Wildcat. He's ready to take the snap. Ronell split out to the left. Herschel with the snap from the 5 to the 10. The field opens up at the 20, the 30, the 40. Midfield, 40, 30, 20, 10. That is an Abilene Eagle touchdown.
We had a great success with a sweep series. We had some great running backs and Glenn Gregory and Jimmy Carpenter. Both of them played in the Southwest Conference. Gregory playing for SMU and Carpenter playing in Oklahoma. So we ran the sweep series. We ran what we call the inside belly series, where you ride the fullback but hand off to the halfback, or pitch it coming back with a counter, and had some great success with that. We did not throw the ball like they throw it now.
Welcome back to the Legends of Texas High School Football, the Abilene Eagles. We're here at Shotwell Stadium. Of course, this is the home for both the Abilene Eagles and the Cooper Cougars. I tell you, when these two teams play, you cannot find a seat here at Shotwell Stadium. Well, speaking of Shotwell, the name, very synonymous for this area here in the big country. P.E. Shotwell was the head coach of the Abilene Eagles. In fact, he led them to their first state title back in 1923. They were known as the Warbirds back then. Here's the story.
I played for Coach Shotwell. Coach Shotwell and Shotwell Stadium, as you know, is named after him. But Coach Shotwell had won state for Abilene High back in the 20s. You didn't call him Coach Shotwell. Everybody called him Mr. Shotwell. And so he was Mr. Shot to everybody. And he was an outstanding coach, too.
Shotwell's Abilene Eagles avenged a 13-0 loss from the previous year to Waco High, doing something no other team had done since 1921, and that was simply score in any form or fashion against the Lions. The Eagles won 3-0. Waco went on to win the state title in 1925, 26, and 27. Pete Shotwell would leave the high school ranks to take over at Hardin-Simmons University. Abilene hired a new head football coach in 1927, and Dewey Mayhew had the Eagles soaring back on top, guiding Abilene to their second state championship in football in 1928. Plus, the school's third state title would come 3 years later in 1931.
My family and my wife's family were both very instrumental in the 20s and 30s of Abilene High School football success. A member of our family, either my immediate family or my wife's family, played on 5 of the 7, I guess it is, state championships that Abilene High School has won.
Shotwell would return in 1946 after Vernon Hilliard coached Abilene for 5 years. The Texas oil boom of the 1950s would usher in a new era in Eagle football. The successor to Shotwell was 34-year-old Chuck Mosier, who was offered a job in 1953 after an impressive coaching stop at McAllen High School. Mosier, who had accepted a head coaching job in Corpus Christi, decided to give Abilene a shot after discussing it with his wife. Mosier talked about it on camera in 1988 on Abilene ISD television.
Hank Watkins was a good friend of mine, and he was the head coach at Donna when I was at McAllen, and he used to come over to my office every Sunday afternoon. We'd talk football about what he was going to do next week and what I was going to do and so on. So when I took this job, the first thing I did is call Hank, and and he came with us. And he is as good a line coach as ever coached the line. There's no question about it. I've always said, give me a quarterback and a great line coach, and you're going to win some ball games, at least move the football.
Hank Watkins and Chuck probably worked together probably as well as any two. Hank was a line coach, and I'll guarantee you what, he could have seven people moving in one unit probably better than anybody I've ever watched. And I've been around with lots of athletics. We had one guy that weighed 201 pounds, and by the time the first week was over with, he was down to 190. And that's the first team that won the state championship in the 50s.
One of Mosier's star players in the mid-1950s was David Borland, who played 3 years of varsity football, beginning on the defensive side of the ball. Discipline was a key factor in Mosier's success, including the original no pass, no play permission slips.
We had eligibility slips way before this no pass, no play came in. This was back in the 50s, and you took that eligibility slip every week to every teacher. And if they put one derogatory remark on that thing, that's 10 100-yard dashes after practice. It didn't make any difference. If he talks too much, that was what I got stuck for.
Oh, really? I can't believe that, boy.
And my teacher put that on there, and he says 10 of them after practice, boy. My senior year, our football team had an 87 average. Everybody, that's the smart guys and all of us guys that were on the bottom. But 87 average.
I don't know how you got by with 1000 and I got my tail busted.
Well,
now you just answer me that question.
Because you can't run.
I'll tell you a little story about Chuck. He smoked. So we had a guy here with my partner named Mold McCook. And he stayed after him all the time about quitting them cigarettes. Every time he'd light one up, he'd say, fire on one end and a fool on the other. So Chuck quit. So he'd come down here one Saturday like he always did. So we'd go eat. And so he had a pack of cigarettes in his pocket. Mo said, Coach, I thought you'd quit. He said, I have. I just want to show these cigarettes that I'm tougher than they are.
This, of course, is the Abilene Zoo, one of the finest in all of the Lone Star State and a great place to bring your youngsters. Well, coming up, we'll introduce you to some of the players who helped put together that incredible 49-game winning streak for the Abilene Eagles when the legends of Texas high school football continues.
This is where it all begins. With seven golf courses, 17 football fields, 25 baseball diamonds, and much more, Abilene is where champions are made.
Hey, hon. You all right?
Gotta pay all these bills and run to the bank to make a deposit.
I could do it. Just have a little yard work to knock out first.
Want to switch?
Okay.
With the new mobile app from First Financial, you can make deposits and pay bills with a snap of a photo, leaving you time to do whatever. First Financial, the first bank in the country with picture pay. You first.
Shouldn't you be helping Mom?
No, I did all the banking.
Courtyard by Marriott in Abilene, where Texas hospitality meets business pleasure. Our newly renovated lobby offers an inviting atmosphere with a comfortable bistro bar and grill, plus a 24-hour full-service business center. Gather in our 1,600-square-foot meeting room, then relax at our new outdoor terrace with our guest barbecue grill and take a dip in the heated pool. Grab a snack and take it up to your newly renovated guest room with a 32-inch flat-screen TV, microwave, and fridge. Or recharge in our 24-hour fitness center. Courtyard by Marriott, located across the street from the Mall of Abilene.
Treat treat your family to amazing Abilene.
Welcome back to the Legends of Texas High School Football, the Abilene Eagles story. We're here at Athletic Supply, originally opened in 1946 in Odessa, but this particular store opened July 29th of 1952. But around back, a place called the Strap House, where a lot of players from the 50s get together and talk football.
The Football Officials Association, of course, here in Abilene, and most of our area football officials were from Abilene. We would film games out at local districts. And when the game was over, the officials would bring the film back into Abilene to have it developed. And they would develop it and deliver it back here to Athletic Supply the next morning. So all the coaches would come in on Saturday morning, pick up their film, and they'd meet here. And of course, they sat around and shot the ball on wide for a long time. Well, as time passed, it's got to be the place to meet.
Moser called the first two, maybe three plays of the game. After that, he taught quarterbacks to call on plays. We changed play at the line of scrimmage in the 50s at least half the time. He'd give us quarterbacks a test every Monday in his office. And he'd hold his little cards up and he'd have 10 basic defenses on it. And he taught us the first thing you do when you come up to the line, you look in front of that center. If there's a man over the center, it's an odd defense, so you know what plays will go against an odd defense. If there's a one over each guard, that's an even defense.
And Chuck always had a special play for every ball game, and he was going to run it straight at their weakness, and it didn't make any difference what happened. You'd have to look it up, but I don't know how many times they scored on the first play of the ball game.
The 49-game winning streak was special for many reasons, but before any rainbow, there's usually a storm. Chuck Mosier's Abilene Eagles of 1954 were no different. Sometimes you have to fail before you can appreciate success. Two of his football players decided to take a journey to California to experience the Hollywood Nights, I guess. But when they returned, things changed at Abilene. Coach Mosier knew the two boys would eventually want back on the team despite their bold move. But this was the perfect time to teach a little life lesson in the process. Here's how former Abilene Eagle David Borland saw it.
We met out in skull practice, and I'll never forget it. We're sitting there, and everybody's listening. He says, these guys we all knew that came back and was in school. And they said, they want back on the team. He said, I'm going to let you boys vote on it. But I vote no. Boy, I guarantee you could have heard a pin drop. He says, anybody want to vote them back on? They don't. Nobody quit me. And that was the end of that deal. But they were our good friends, don't get me wrong. And they were his good friends. I guarantee you that's the way he said it. And I mean, you talk about scared to death. I like jumped out of my seat when he said that.
The 49-game winning streak did not begin until after the Eagles were dismantled by a very talented Breckenridge team that went on to win the 3A state title in 1954. This was the turning point in not only the season for Abilene, but it marked the last loss for the Eagles, who won their next 49 games in a row, which was a national record in 11-man football at the time. Abilene beat Borger 34-7 and simply refused to lose. Chuck Mosier's first state title came in the fall of 54 against Stephen F. Austin out of Houston, who were led by future Texas Longhorn Vince Matthews. Despite five turnovers, the Eagles found themselves in a dogfight. Abilene quarterback H.B. Hawkins tossed this 29-yard touchdown pass in the final minute to Twyman Ash to win it 14-7.
Twyman Ash caught a big pass in the state championship ball game in 54 that helped that ball club win the state championship.
It won the game. A minute and 58 seconds left in the game.
You were a defensive back then.
I was a defensive back then.
The 1955 and 56 seasons were total domination for Abilene. The Eagles averaged 35 points per contest and held opponents to single digits 39 times during the 49-game winning streak and did not allow a passing touchdown 33 times. The Eagles led by at least 20 points at halftime of 36 of those games. In the 1955 state championship, the Eagles squared off against Tyler, who was led by All-State quarterback Charlie Milstead.
Abilene shut Tyler out for three quarters and went on to win 33-13 behind their own stud, Glenn Gregory, who ran for 171 yards and two touchdowns.
We had, at that time, we had a bunch of great athletes. Glenn Gregory, Stuart Peak, and a bunch of guys. We had played together for a number of years. Our first really success was when we were 14 and we went to the Pony League World Series in Pennsylvania. First time most of us ever flew in an airplane. Coach Moser was probably one of the best coaches I ever had. I went to Oklahoma after graduation and played. But Coach Moser, our system was such that we didn't make very many mistakes.
In 1956, Jimmy Carpenter was the star running back for Abilene. In the state championship game, he rushed for 227 yards and had a pair of long touchdown runs of 62 and 94 yards as the Eagles soared past Corpus Christi Ray 14-0.
Corpus Christi Ray had a bunch of big, great athletes who later played in college. It was probably the best game I ever played.
Abilene's 49-game winning streak was eventually snapped by Highland Park in the state semifinals in a 20-all tie. HP advanced on a 5-3 edge in penetration inside the 20-yard line. The season was over, and so was the winning streak.
I was a player on the 1957 team that was tied by Highland Park that stopped the winning streak. And, of course, we were heartbroken. But as we were coming back into town, cars lined the road with banners and people honking, saying how proud they were of us. That meant a lot.
The gold jerseys that Abilene wore were a big part of their success, whether it was a superstition or simply an easier way to carry out the fake, considering the football sort of looked like those jerseys. Even today, the Eagles wear throwback uniforms to honor those great Abilene teams of the 1950s.
They come out in those jerseys. I'm telling you, the stands erupted. It's just a tradition with everything. When Steve Warren come in, he wanted to turn it back like Chuck Moser did. And so he even had Chuck down here to make a speech to the kids. He wanted it to be like it was when Chuck Moser was here. And I think that did help a lot.
And I think that when Steve took over, we had that deal. Boss, you were there when they dedicated the field house, Chuck Moser Field House, made it. So that's the way he kept everything going.
He had the whole town interested in the Abilene Eagles in those 3 years.
Coming up, we'll introduce you to Moser's successor, Wally Bullington.
Chuck was a great mentor.
And later, the Steve Warren era would usher in a new streak.
It was unbelievable how many black and gold clad people were there to watch the Eagles.
The legends of Texas high school football continues in a moment.
I am Abilene.
I'm Abilene.
I am Abilene.
I am Abilene.
Abilene is more than just my hometown.
More than where I live.
More than where I thrive.
More than where I work.
More than where I learn.
Abilene is the place to meet.
The place to stay.
The place to play.
Abilene is true Southern hospitality.
True Southern experiences.
Where memories are made.
Abilene is me.
Is me.
Is me.
I am Abilene. Abilene.
MCM Elegante Suites, Abilene's only four-star all-suite hotel. 175 two-room suites, free full cook-to-order breakfast, free manager's reception, and a heated indoor pool. Whether you need to stay a night or stay a while, we've got what it takes to make you feel right at home. From business meetings in our spacious courtyard to shopping and entertainment across the street, MCM Elegante Suites in Abilene is the place to be. Welcome back to the legends of Texas high school football. The Abilene Eagles, winners of seven state championships on the gridiron dating back to the 1920s, all the way up to the current era under Steve Warren. Of course, they won a title in 2009. Here in downtown Abilene, it is a Chamber of Commerce kind of day. A special thanks to the Abilene Convention and Visitors Bureau for that. Right behind me, Cypress Street, you see the Grace Museum and of course the Paramount Theater, absolutely beautiful. Buffalo Gap, another fantastic place to visit when you're in the big country, one of the most beautiful parts of the Lone Star State.
Pete Shotwell, Chuck Mosier, Steve Warren, all great coaches here for the Abilene Eagles, all need good assistance. Wally Bullington comes to mind. He coached the Eagles from 1960 to 1965. Here's his story.
Tell us how you met Chuck Mosier. What was he like as a coach, as a person, and what did you like about him?
My senior year in college at Abilene Christian, Chuck Mosier was hired. That was 1953. He had called my head coach, who was Garvin Beecham, and said, I need a couple of seniors to come over and help me. I haven't filled out my coaching staff yet. So I was chosen along with Ted Sitton, our quarterback. We went over and worked about 3 weeks with Chuck Mosier, and I got to know him. Evidently, he liked some of the things he saw in me as a possibility of a coach. So about 2 months later, he called me and offered me a job. And it was one of the best things that ever happened to me. Chuck was a great mentor for me. I could not have been under a better head coach starting out coaching than Chuck Mosier.
You played center and linebacker as a player, and then you got a chance to coach on the line as well. Games were won back then on the line of scrimmage, weren't they?
Yes. Chuck always said, you know, in the close ball games, you're going to win most of the time if you cut down turnovers, fumbles. He worked real hard on fundamentals. So he worked there, and he also worked the kicking game. Even though he was a strict disciplinarian, the kids really loved playing for him.
The term Warbirds, what does it mean? Tell us your thoughts about it.
Well, it just indicates that here is a school that has great pride in their teams, in all sports, and especially the Eagles. And I can remember getting a mascot, a live eagle, and a cage was built, and they'd bring that eagle, which was named Champ, to the ball games. But the Warbirds was a great name for Abilene High School.
Bullington coached several standout players, including Dave Parks, who had a fantastic 10-year career in the NFL and was drafted number one overall in 1964 by the San Francisco 49ers.
Last time I ever stepped off the football field, I was using the same basic techniques that I learned from his staff. Wally Bullington was great. I tell you, the group in front of me, God, they were so fantastic. I mean, they're like a machine. We had linemen that were almost as fast as some of our backs. And it was amazing how they would score it just bang.
We didn't throw the ball as much, but running play action passes, we had a lot of success when we did throw it. Not many coaches get to spend their whole career in one town. Definition of a successful coach is when he's being run out of town, he can make it appear he's leading a parade in his honor. You've got to be a salesman that way.
We're here at Shotwell Stadium, of course, home to both Abilene and Cooper. Well, the first African-American football player to letter at Abilene High School was Petty Hunter. In fact, he was part of the first integrated class at Abilene High School.
Well, first of all, I started the process of integration in junior high school. And that transition for me was a big leap. So in the spring of 66, I expressed my desire to play varsity ball, and they took me up. So as a sophomore, I played both offense and defense, and played a center and middle linebacker. Being the only African-American on the team, for most of the white guys, it was kind of difficult because I was new. I was different. And the Times said that we weren't supposed to get along, but we bonded very well. We became one. We became a team. They protected me better than I'd ever understood.
Petty's mother, her name's Dorothy May, worked for my wife's family. I have two children, a son and a daughter, but if my wife and I were going out of town or going out at night, well, Dorothy May was basically their grandmother.
So I was never really exposed to some of the behaviors that I was told about. As we jokingly talk about it today, I integrated Shotwell.
Soon after that, in the 1970s, the Eagles dropped from the ranks of the top teams in the state of Texas, and it seemed like just making the playoffs would be an accomplishment all to itself.
From 1988 to 95, the Eagles had 8 consecutive losing seasons. Gary Gaines was brought on to coach Abilene, but ran into some of the same trouble other coaches had. Gaines had an assistant coach, though, who would be perfect for the job, Steve Warren, who was on top of a roof in San Angelo in the middle of the summer of 1996 when he got the call.
We bantered back and forth, and I said, let's hire Steve Warren, and kind of talked back and forth, and everyone agreed, okay, let's hire Steve Warren. He'd only been here 2 years, too, as the assistant coach. Gary brought him in, and it was just the way he related, not only to the players, but he related to our other students. We got on the phone with the superintendent, who I believe was in Russia, and talked to him, and he said, okay, find him. I want to make this announcement tonight before the San Angelo board meets and hires Gary Gaines. We're going to have us a coach before Gary gets hired. I got on, I called the house. Carol answered. That's his wife, and I said, Carol, I need to talk to Steve.
Well, the principal called me at work, which has never happened the whole time we've been married. So I was thinking, woo-wee, this could be good or this could be something crazy. It was great. We just got right on it.
Steve and I met down here at the field house, said about 4, and we talked and, you know, offered them a job. So the rest is history. We hired Steve that night. Things were, you know, just started getting progressively better.
We reconnected to some of the most special teams that have ever played Texas high school football. And we've been able to do that, and I'm really, really proud of all of our kids that have been a part of that along the way, because it's taken us all to do it. And there's been a lot of great teams and a lot of great players and a lot of great fans, and it's been a lot of fun doing it.
When he took the job, you know, I immediately was the tee boy, run out the middle, get the tee, and then I graduated to the ball boy, and then at some point, I was quarterback.
Speaking of quarterback, coming up.
Hey, trust me, I wanted to.
Former Abilene Eagle Ahmad Brooks relives a moment he won't soon forget. His first touchdown, and it came against Art Briles and the mighty Stephenville Yellow Jackets.
I was running for my life.
Plus,
I'm Crystal Dominguez here at the ballpark in Arlington. When we return, I'll introduce you to a Boston Red Sox pitcher who used to play for the Abilene Eagles. When we return.
For Boston, number 41, John Blackie.
Working with a realtor means the focus is on you, whether it's buying or selling your home. Ken England has 31 years of real estate experience in this community and is excited about the positive growth of Abilene.
I know that I can find the right home for you and your family.
With their Tavern Double Burger for just $6.99, Red Robin truly has a burger for everyone. Even those of us who don't have a burger daddy. 24 burgers, a million reasons.
Red Robin.
Yum.
Someone once said, all good things must come to an end. Red Robin's bottomless steak fries sure do make that guy look like a liar. Booyah.
24 burgers, a million reasons.
Red Robin.
Yum.
Postnet, for all your printing, faxing, and shipping needs. We are your neighborhood business center located in the HEB Shopping Center, 603 Lewis Hanna Boulevard, Suite 197 in Round Rock.
Welcome back to the Legends of Texas High School Football, the Abilene Eagles story. Steve Warren's first year at Abilene High School was the last year for John Lackey, who might be the most recognizable athlete in Abilene history. Of course, Lackey now pitches for the Boston Red Sox. You might remember he was drafted by the LA Angels of Anaheim, played 3 sports for the Eagles, basketball, baseball, and football. Crystal Dominguez caught up with him at the ballpark in Arlington.
I'm here at the ballpark in Arlington with Boston Red Sox pitcher John Lackey. But not only has he been in the major leagues for over a decade, he was also the quarterback for the Abilene Eagles. Well, welcome back to Texas.
Yeah, I always have people here when I come back to play here. My first start in the big leagues with the Angels was here against the Rangers. So have a lot of history of playing here, and you know, came here as a kid, you know, to watch the Rangers, and was a Rangers fan, you know, growing up. So it's always fun to come back here.
John Lackey.
I love playing football. I played football, basketball, and baseball at Abilene High. So it was a great experience. I think, you know, my football experience, you know, definitely the competing aspects, and you know, getting knocked around a little bit. Shotwell Stadium's a lot of fun. It gets packed, especially when we play Cooper, our, you know, crosstown rival. So it was always a lot of good memories.
Do you still follow the Warbirds?
Absolutely, yeah. I remember when I was playing for the Angels, actually watched their state championship game in a bar in California. So yeah, I definitely still follow them. I split a little time my senior year with Ahmad Brooks, played a little quarterback too, and he ended up making it to the NFL and was a really great player at UT. So it was a fun experience all around.
What would you want to give back to that community, a community that raised you in sports and really showed you the way?
I just hope it's, you know, fun for some of those kids that growing up in Abilene in those little leagues to see a guy that came from the same little leagues that they made it to the big leagues. And then, you know, it's possible, and if they you know, work at it and, you know, get a little luck and have a little skill.
Well, John Lackey, thank you for your time here at the ballpark in Arlington. I'm Crystal Dominguez. Back to you, Jeff.
Thanks, Crystal.
Head coach Steve Warren was brought in from Rotan, and of course, he has had a very successful run as the head coach of the Abilene Eagles. They've made 14 consecutive playoff appearances. Here's his former quarterback, Ahmad Brooks, with more over at Shotwell Stadium.
I'm Ahmad Brooks, class of 1998 here at Abilene High School. And I want to take you back to a play back when we were in Stephenville, a midline option dive fake here to the fullback where I was quarterback at the time. I spin out.
The guard pulls.
A nice little pitch fake out to my running back.
Some of this, and the next thing you know, 79 yards later.
79 yards later, we're in the game on the road in Stephenville.
I was running for my life. Those kids from Stephenville were big, ferocious.
They were coming off, I think, their second or third state championship. And that was the second game that I'd ever coached as a head coach.
My first play, all I could think was, is I didn't want it to be my last at quarterback. So, Coach, I appreciate that.
It was good stuff.
It really helped my career.
Well,
it,
and mine.
The building blocks were being put into place. The Abilene Eagles could almost see a playoff berth for the first time in 40 years. In that 1998 season, the Eagles had a standout receiver, Bryson Galloway. He could certainly see the light at the end of the tunnel. The Abilene Eagles were relevant again.
You know, in 98, we had some expectations to do some things and kind of put us in a position to hopefully make the playoffs. The thing that stuck out most was when Steve came in as the coach and he talked to us the first time. He said, guys, we're going to get this thing turned around and we're going to go to the playoffs. And if you don't believe me, you need to go do something else because that's just what we're going to do here. And he couldn't help but buy into a program that had that kind of leader.
So impressed with how the kids worked and their work ethic and how organized Steve was, and I was like, you know, these guys are on the verge of winning.
Coach Warren told us we could win from day one, and we all believe that.
The game against Midland, I mean, of all games, an arch rival, and you guys end up going on to make it to the playoffs.
Getting the kickoff in the second half and maintaining ball control a lot of the second half and eating up a lot of that clock and ultimately going on to win that game. That we did clinch the playoffs for the first time in 40 years, and that was a pretty cool feeling.
Our opinion here in Abilene is pretty high, Steve Warren. And if you go back and you look and check through the history books of the 40-plus year drought, some people refer to it as a drought, some of us refer to it as a famine.
You ended up getting all the way to the quarterfinals, and from that point forward, boy, the Abilene High train has just continued to roll on.
Olympian Jonathan Johnson represented Abilene High football with world-class speed at the wide receiver position.
I mean, we were pretty much laying the foundation that Coach Warren always put into place.
Johnson broke a 5A state high school record in the 800 meters in Austin when he won the event in a time of 1:48.21 in 2001. Johnson also anchored the mile relay team to gold as well. Abilene won the team championship in the biggest classification in the state of Texas. Johnson went on to Texas Tech where he won 9 All-America honors, 4 consecutive Big 12 championships in the 800 meters, and he was an NCAA champion in 2004. In that same year, Johnson won the U.S. Olympic trials and had the fastest time by an American at 1:44.7. Johnson reached the finals in the 2004 Olympics in Athens, Greece.
That work ethic was everything, and I went out there and I did everything that I could for the team, and I made sure I took care of my part first.
Steve Warren's Abilene Eagles went unbeaten in 2004 and 2005 during the regular season, but lost to South Lake Carroll in the 5A Division II regionals both years. Future Texas Tech Red Raider Taylor Potts was sensational at Abilene, completing 230 of 332 passes for 3,162 yards and 23 touchdowns in his senior season alone. Potts was one of 3 quarterbacks from the Abilene area that went on to stellar careers at the collegiate level. Not only did Potts throw for over 7,800 yards passing in his career at Texas Tech, but Abilene Wiley High School's Case Keenum became the all-time leader in total touchdown passing yards, touchdowns, and completions by a Football Bowl Subdivision Series quarterback at the University of Houston, and is the only FBS quarterback to have passed for more than 5,000 yards in each of three different seasons. Keenum led Wiley to the Class 3A state title over Cuero in 2004 and had close to 6,800 yards passing and 89 touchdowns for his career at Wiley. Then there was Colt McCoy from Jim Ned High School just south of Abilene in Tuscola. Of course, he is still considered one of the greatest quarterbacks to ever play for the Longhorns and is the all-time leader in career passing yards and TD passes in UT history. It was a magical run for Potts, Keenum, and McCoy in the mid-2000s, and they have a theory about why Abilene is such a quarterback hotbed.
I think every single one of us went to air it out camp. That Coach Ward has always puts on, and he used to put it on at Hardin-Simmons when we were growing up.
You know, Case grew up not too far from me. Taylor was there at Abilene High. I went to the small school, but I know we all experienced success, and that was pretty neat. Football is huge there. Whether you're in a small school or a big school like Abilene High, lots of great athletes, lots of great coaches. Jim Ned, small school, not many people know about it. A lot of people have heard of Abilene High, but, you know, just being able to be around the game in that area for so long and grow up there, pretty special.
Coming up, we'll take you onto the field here at Shotwell Stadium with Coach Steve Warren and one of his star players, Ahmad Brooks, when the legends of Texas high school football, the Abilene Eagles story, continues. The legends of Texas high school football, the Abilene Eagles story, would like to thank our gold level sponsors, including Ambit Energy, a top electricity and gas provider with customer service that makes people happy. Start the journey to financial freedom with Ambit Energy, located in Dallas, Texas. Ferris Consulting, your information technology specialist. We've designed, implemented, and supported hundreds of computer networks, and our goal is to provide you with an outstanding level of service you will not find anywhere else on the street. Ferris Consulting.
Looking to upgrade to a new Chevrolet, Cadillac, Buick, or GMC car, truck, or SUV? At Lawrence Hall in Abilene, you'll find a great selection of what you're looking for, including the most dependable trucks with the best pickup coverage in the industry and 2 years maintenance, plus great fuel-efficient cars with over 15 models rated 30 MPG or higher. So shop at home and save at Lawrence Hall in Abilene. No big city tricks and gimmicks, just our best deals every day.
Action Zone is building champions in Abilene at the new state-of-the-art athletic facility for professionals, amateurs, and families alike. From group fitness, personal training, boot camps, and more, there's over 20,000 square feet of space to help you stay active. Sprint on our indoor and outdoor football fields, or take a leap of faith, pole vaulting, spiking a volleyball, or hooping it up. Cycle on the only real rider indoor cycling studio in West Texas. From skill and strength development to dance and yoga, Action Zone is building champions one day at a time.
Red Robin's bottomless freckled lemonade is officially my new favorite drink. Sorry, iced tea. You had your chance. And you blew it.
24 burgers, a million reasons.
Red Robin.
Yum.
Red Robin's fiery ghost-style burger, made from the hottest pepper on earth, can satisfy your craving for something spicy. Plus, it can keep your taste buds warm for like 20 years.
24 burgers, a million reasons.
Red Robin.
Yum.
In 2007, the Abilene Eagles did something that no other Abilene team had done before them, and that was defeat Southlake Carroll, snapping their 58-game winning streak against teams from the Lone Star State. Their quarterback on that day was Spence Lackey, who will always be remembered as the Eagle who slayed the Dragon.
Our good friend, Marcus Brooks, he had just passed away, and he was a huge, huge factor on the field. Like you said, as a nose guard, and he was a beast on the D-line. It came down to that last play. They were driving on us. We couldn't stop them. And they tried to take that one snap too many, and Marcus just reached down from the heavens and swatted out the way. We got lucky enough to come up with it, and that was that. You know, all we had to do was kneel the ball after that, and that was the game.
When you're a quarterback at Abilene High School, there's a certain amount of expectation that's placed on you, and you got to be a great player. There's no doubt. And you mentioned Spence, and, you know, he took our program to the semifinals, and what a great job he did, you know, when he was our quarterback. And that was a place that we'd not ever been before in a long, long time. And, you know, my son Steven followed Spence and kind of led us into a new district. We'd been in the old Little Southwest Conference for years, and so everything was brand new.
Well, you know, my dad always said, all the people in front of you have paved the way to get to where you are today. He set it into a position where we weren't going to fail.
The 2008 season was one of high expectations, partly because the University Interscholastic League's realignment had placed Abilene in District 3-5A away from the Midland, Odessa, and Lubbock schools and introduced Abilene to Fort Worth ISD. After a perfect 10-0 regular season, Abilene lost their first playoff game to Mansfield in a bi-district matchup that really left an empty feeling for a team that had accomplished so much in a short period of time.
We played a guy by the name of Stephen Taylor, a Heisman candidate from Stanford University, and we ran into a little bit of an issue, and it was kind of a disappointment to a really good season.
That would take us to 2009, where the Eagles once again rolled through District 3-5A and were undefeated. The matchup with Cedar Hill would be a tough test for the Eagles.
Every week we kept saying, we're undefeated, but how good are we? We weren't sure. Then we played Cedar Hill. It was just phenomenal.
Several plays stood out in this game, including a defensive stand that was made possible by a player who never gave up on what was sure to be a long touchdown run for Cedar Hill, who were the number one team in the state. Dreyfus Jackson connected with Ben Molina on a 65-yard screen pass, but a touchdown-saving tackle at the one proved to be the spark of momentum that Abilene needed.
And he's going to finally be knocked out of bounds before he gets into the end zone.
Carson Goodman chasing down Ben Molina, tackling him on the one-yard line when he could easily just, you know, I'm not going to make it.
After three failed attempts to score, Abilene's defense sniffed out this shovel pitch on fourth and goal to Molina, and took over on downs at their own 5-yard line.
The Eagles have come up with a remarkable goal line stand. They take over at their own 5-yard line.
You know, they had four shots to get in the end zone from the 1-yard line, and they didn't do it.
Abilene quarterback Ronnell Sims was nursing a groin injury, so the Eagles rode the legs of running back Herschel Sims, who had 30 carries, none bigger than this 95-yard sprint for a touchdown on the first play of the ensuing drive.
It's obvious I'm going to get the ball right there. We need to get away from the end zone. You know, so the call was Bird right, 46 quarterback, and of course he couldn't keep it there because he was lined up at receiver. So it was just me and Tony Curtis in the backfield. Tony was lined up on the wrong side. And then when we finally got him on the right side, we saw it was the best defensive end. He switched to the other side, and right then and there I knew it was a piece of cake.
Sims finished with 276 yards rushing as this sprint for six broke open a 10-point game as the Eagles went on to win it 41-17, shocking the entire state. From there, the Eagles would have to face a team from the greater Houston area, the Klein Bearcats.
Klein gave us a challenge. We barely beat them 29-21.
Ronnell goes into the end zone for an Eagle touchdown.
Channing Curtis has more on Ronnell Sims, who had his coming out party on the biggest stage.
Right now, Ronnell Sims plays running back here at SMU, but he had his best running performance at quarterback for the Abilene Eagles in their 2009 state championship game.
That 09 team just did everything right.
Ronnell Sims rushed for 215 yards on the ground, and most of that came on just one or two plays that the Katy Tigers had a hard time stopping. The sweep check, as it was known, was a play Ronnell ran to perfection all day long at the Alamo Dome. Sims scored his first of three touchdowns just 29 seconds into the game, sprinting 47 yards for six.
Coming up to the game, the coach's game plan had told me I was going to be running a lot, but I didn't think 30 carries was going what it came down to. But yeah, pretty much we ran basically the same play the whole game, either a sweep right or a sweep left, and they couldn't stop it, so we just continued to run it.
Sims would add his second touchdown just 7 minutes later as Abilene raced out to a 14-0 lead. The Eagles would add to their lead in the fourth quarter as Ronnell scored his third touchdown as Abilene went on to win 28-17.
Most of the time it was just really Herschel and other running backs or a team effort, but like I said, that state game was just something different. They were so keyed in on Herschel, and I guess they didn't have really a game plan for me, and I just took over the game.
I didn't have a breakout game like I did in the other games, I'll say, but I ended up over 100 yards just based off of one run towards the end. But you know, they had a backup plan. They went to my cousin Ronnell, and you know, Katy wasn't prepared for that. You know, so Ronnell played a big part in that game.
We were having success running Ronnell, you know, and he was getting tired and gassed, and Coach Warren said, hey, let's lay off Ronnell, run, get Herschel involved, and we run a play that we've always ran, and this time it broke, and he broke it for about 70 and down the right sideline and ended up scoring all the way in the left corner of the end zone and cut it all the way back across the field.
They rode my back the whole way there, but we needed Ronnell to win it for us.
For the Eagles, it was the icing on the cake, their first state title in 53 years. Rennell had several family members on the 2009 Abilene Eagles squad, including two younger brothers and his first cousin, Herschel. It was truly all in the family.
I didn't really think about the 53 years. I just thought it was cool because I have two brothers played on defense. And then the guy who I lived with in high school was a middle linebacker. And of course I played with my cousin. And not many people get to play with their family members.
Man, that's a season to remember. It's something that I'll never forget. You know, it's growing up, I've been to plenty of Abilene High games, and they've always had great teams, but never had a team to take Coach Warren to state, you know. So I'm just thankful and blessed that I was able to be a part of that team.
It was special because Ahmad Brooks was there to be a part of it. It was special because my dad was right there with me, and my brothers and my whole family. And, you know, a lot of people, I mean, I can just remember turning around. It was unbelievable how many black and gold clad people were there to watch the Eagles. And a pretty big day, pretty special.
The clock struck zero, seeing Coach Warren dance around like a crazy man, and hugging his dad was an awesome moment to see. And it was great to see Ahmad out here, former Abilene High guy. He was interviewing on the field, so it was really a lot of cool moments there in the as soon as we just won the state championship.
You know, the 2009 Abilene Eagles had one motto, Brothers Keeper. And I think that's a great title for a team that not only treated each other like brothers, but they had each other's backs as well. For the legends of Texas high school football, I'm Channing Curtis. Now back to you, Jeff.
Thanks, Channing. Coming up, an inspiring young boy lifts the Eagles to new heights.
You know, Rex loved Abilene High School. He loved Coach Warren. You know, he took that with him to where he is now.
When the legends of Texas high school football continues.
Hey, hon. You all right?
Gotta pay all these bills and run to the bank to make a deposit.
I could do it. Just have a little yard work to knock out first.
Wanna switch?
Okay.
With the new mobile app from First Financial, you can make deposits and pay bills with a snap of a photo, leaving you time to do whatever. First Financial, the first bank in the country with picture pay. You first.
Shouldn't you be helping Mom?
No, I did all the banking.
Treat your family to amazing Abilene.
One of the biggest supporters of Abilene football was Rex Fleming. This young little boy was at the Alamo Dome in San Antonio when the Abilene Eagles defeated the Katy Tigers to claim their seventh state championship in 2009. But later on in 2010, at the age of 10, Rex was diagnosed with brain cancer. The Fleming family will never forget the next couple of years as Steve Warren and the Abilene Eagles really adopted this young boy.
You know, in 2010, when he was diagnosed with cancer, that began a really neat two-year relationship between Rex and Coach Warren and the Abilene High football team. They really rallied around him and rallied around our family after we learned that Rex was not going to live through this, that his cancer was going to take his life. Coach Warren called me and said, hey, we want Rex to be a part of our team. He has been for 2 years, but we want him on the field. He got to experience that. And Evan Abbey and Kevin Lucas and some of those guys that were captains of the team last year, Conlon Aguirre, presented Rex with a wristband that only the varsity team members had, and we buried him with it.
In 2012, Rex lost his battle with cancer, and the Abilene High football team wore stickers that simply said, go deep. A play that Rex always told Coach Warren to run. Eagles quarterback Evan Abbey had a strong bond with Rex and spoke at his funeral.
He and Evan have a special bond. I don't know if it was the red hair, freckle face thing. Maybe that's what it was. I don't know. But whatever it was very special. And you know, certainly he was some young man that really meant a lot to our entire program in a lot of ways. And I certainly, you know, felt very, very fortunate to get close to that young man.
It was very meaningful to our family. Very special few months that he enjoyed with these guys. And I believe the first play that Abilene High ran on that Friday night was a deep pass. They almost broke it for a touchdown. They went deep on the first play.
Abby became the first Abilene quarterback to complete 400 passes in a career. He also surpassed Taylor Potts' record of 51 career touchdown passes with his 52nd in a hard-fought loss to Waco Midway as the Eagles finished 2012 12-1 overall.
Welcome back to Shotwell Stadium. We're now joined by the head football coach of the Abilene High Eagles, one of my former coaches, Steve Warren. Coach, I appreciate your time, and let's get right into it. Your first year, it's 1996. You're handed the head coaching job here of this program as Gary Gaines leaves for another job. And I remember walking into your office and how motivated you were to take this job. Looking back now, what a moment that was for you. And just talk about how you motivate your teams and your players, even though we didn't have really a winning mentality, to get to the point where you are now.
We just took the reins and took off with it. I was full of so much energy. I was 32 years old.
I remember.
And had a lot of big eyes in front of me like yourself that I felt like we could motivate and have some success, not just in football, but off the field. And so we started down that path together, and you guys helped lay the foundation, and here we are today talking about it.
Coach, you talked about wanting your players to win off the field, and I can attest to this as a young man, the type of effort and energy you put into making sure that we were good people off the field. But it was that winning attitude and that competitive fire that you still have on the sideline, Coach, that has allowed this program to do what it's done. Talk about the winning attitude and approach that you have to coaching, and where did that come from?
Well, you know, it came from my parents. You know, my mom and dad were educators, and my dad was my coach, and he was such a positive role model, you know, for me. And all I knew was just to go try to win at everything we did. And when I saw the program that I felt like we could build, I wanted to start off by making everybody understand that it was important to me to take guys like yourself and many, many others and help them become winners off the field. And then the winning on the field would happen.
Yes, sir.
You know, when that happened. And obviously a bunch of guys like yourself, you know, bought in. And here we go. It started rolling like that. It's been an awesome experience. Practice winning every day. You heard it at Abilene High. You've heard it at Texas when you played it for the University of Texas. You guys laid the foundation for the success that we had in 99 because we started talking about being a playoff team. And I'm a firm believer in you got to set your goals and talk about them and before people start believing it. You know, in 2001, we were able to win the first district title in almost 50 years. That was a goal to bring the bell back home. You know, this was its home in the 50s.
8 years, you move it forward. I remember what it was like being in that Alamo Dome, going up against the big bad Katie, who has a wonderful program. I know you respect what they've done. But that 2009 team that won the state title was not intimidated at all by Katie. You come in there, you get a state title, and for people who know the story, like myself, it was hard to control your emotions. Coach, take us back down memory lane and talk about what that 2009 team and that state title meant.
You know, that was another step in the process of building this program. And it was a special day out there. It was our time, you know, and it was an emotional time, but good night, what a special day for our community to be able to tie that recent winning tradition back to what it used to be like.
Wow.
And that was really something special for myself and the staff and everybody in Abilene.
That winning tradition that dates back to that first district title in 2001. Since then, Coach, you've won 7 district titles and brought the bell back right here to this place here in Shotwell Stadium. How have you managed to keep the success of a program like this now, that since the expectations are as high as they've ever been?
You know, that's the thing that you, when you come to work every single day, you got to have high goals and you got to have high expectations, and we do everything we can to maintain it. You know, the continuity of my staff is so important to me. You know, Coach Fuller and Coach Cox, some of the guys that came before them, you know, Coach Ramish, those guys are the backbone of what goes on. You know, they believe in me. They believe in the direction that we want to take the program every single day. The expectations are through the roof. We step on the field every day practicing winning, and not just in football, but everything we do, and because of that expectation, I really feel like that helps us win on Friday nights, without a doubt. And the kids believe in what we do. You know, our goals are the same. We don't waver. We think we can win a state championship next year. We think we can win another district title. We think we're going to the playoffs for the 15th straight year. And our kids believe that when they get in our program. And so, you know, we're very, very fortunate to have in place something we feel like is really special.
Coach, it's hard to believe that it's almost been 20 years since you took this job as a 32-year-old, but it's amazing the run that you and your staff and these players have been able to accomplish. Coach, We always appreciate you sharing your time.
You bet.
Thanks,
you.
Coach.
Thank you.
Jeff, back to you, my man.
Of course, Ahmad Brooks, a former Buffalo Bill. Well, these are the Flying Buffalo here on the parade grounds at Frontier, Texas, on a beautiful, sunny, Lone Star State kind of afternoon. Well, that puts a wrap on our Abilene Eagles, one of many Texas high school football legendary teams across this Lone Star State. We'd like to thank our special title sponsor, the Abilene Convention and Visitors Bureau, and everyone else who was a part of this one. We leave you now with some sights and sounds of Eagle football.
Playing ball is a lot of fun, but there's nothing more exciting than watching your son play out there and doing well and having success. It's a lot of fun. There's a lot of excitement. You know, everybody's got a sticker on the car, and when you're driving down I-20 and passing somebody or somebody passes you, you always look and see who it is because of the number that's on the back, but it's kind of like a big family.
You know, this year with my son, you know, having the opportunity to play, it's going to be a lot of fun sitting up here with a lot of pride.
This is the oldest marching band in Texas. It was started in 1926 by Raymond Bynum. Every team that comes here knows what they're going to get from us, and we like it that way.
And I count them, we had 10. I run in there and I was a tackle for one play and I weighed 140 pounds.
But he said, boy, that's important. So you'll get in trouble.
143.
Look what the team of the century is. It's a team from Abilene.
Once an Eagle, always an Eagle.